Good morning, children. Welcome to Chapter 5 Community Services, Part 3. In previous videos, we discussed about community services, importance of trees, water sources, those are wells, step wells, cones, cisindras, all. In this video, we are going to learn about water harvesting, community service in modern times. Water harvesting. What is water harvesting? Water harvesting is the technique of collecting, storing and using rainwater for irrigation, drinking and other purposes. Rainwater. During the rainy season, we will get so much rainwater that all the water, if you observe, that all rainwater will flow from upwards to downwards and it will mix with the drains and it will flow on the roads and finally it will enter into the sea or ocean. So in seasoned oceans, water is salty water. So that salty water we can't use for irrigation or drinking or any other purpose. That's why before entering into the seas or oceans, the rainwater should be stored. That is only called as water harvesting. So once again, what is water harvesting? Water harvesting is the technique of collecting, storing and using rainwater for irrigation. Irrigation means water supply to the agricultural fields, drinking and other purposes. Other purposes means for domestic use all, washing, cleaning for that all. So in olden times, India had a well-developed system of water harvesting, not only in recent times, since olden times, in our country, we had a well-developed system of water harvesting. Each village saved rainwater to fulfill its requirement in the dry months. In each village, those people, they used to save the rainwater for to fulfill the requirement. That means their needs in dry months. Dry months means when they won't get rainfall in summer season. That all, they will use this water. There was no shortage of water at that time. That means no shortage of water. That means sufficient water they used to have. Many of the traditional water sources exist even today. Unfortunately, most of them are in ruins due to neglect and poor maintenance. So traditional water sources, what are those? Wells, okay, and kuns, like that. So many traditional water sources are exist today also, but what happened to them? Unfortunately, most of them are in ruins due to neglect and poor maintenance. Ruins means damaged. Because of what they damaged? Our negligence and poor maintenance. That's why we have to maintain it properly. Anything, if you maintain properly, then it will be useful to us. In recent times, efforts have been made to revive the old water bodies and to popularize water harvesting. In recent times, what they are doing? They are revive the old water bodies. What are the water bodies? Are they traditional water sources? All they are doing some repairs to that, and they are giving popularity about the water harvesting. How we can harvest the water? At every house also we can do the water harvesting. How? In our buildings, before our house, we have to dig a pit, and in that pit we have to keep some pebbles all, and we have to fill it with soil. Then all the rainwater should, we have to allow all the rainwater to enter into that pit. Then in that area, that all the rainwater will be shrink. Then what will happen? That we can, like that, we can reach as the groundwater level. Then we won't face any time water scarcity in our areas. It saves rainwater from getting drained and wasted. Water harvesting saves rainwater from getting drained and wasted. Drained means where it will drain to seas and oceans. Once it will enter into sea or ocean, it will also turn into salty water. Then that all the salt water we can't use for any time irrigation or domestic purpose. That's why before entering into the seas or oceans, that rain water we should collect and we should store it, and we have to use properly that water, that rainwater. That's why we can say water harvesting saves rainwater from getting drained and wasted. And it solves the problem of water scarcity also. If we do the water harvesting, then we can solve the problem of water scarcity. Water scarcity means shortage of water. Okay. So like this for every building. See here one building is there. Here rain will fall like this. All the rainwater will be collected and it will flow through this pipe and it will enter into the service well. Means in that ground they will dig the earth just like a well. Okay, and all the rainwater will be allowed to go into this well. Like this, around the building also some water will fall. Now that all the water, for this they will keep holes like this there, that all the water will sink into the ground. Down how they will do? They will dig the earth and down they will keep some pebbles, that all the rainwater will be allowed to sink in the ground. Like that we can recharge the groundwater level also. Now community services in modern times. Community living requires organization, coordination and tolerance. Community living means in the society all the people are living together. Okay, so what it will require? Organization. That means what we are doing, that all we have to do in an organized manner. For that we should have an organization. And coordination among the people, all always we should have the coordination. And tolerance also. Instead of kings, Now the government and its agencies look after the community services. Before time, in olden times, kings used to think about the welfare of the people and they used to do the community service. Now, who are doing now? The government and its agencies look after the community services. And some charity trusts also, they are doing the community service. Each neighborhood requires essential services like water, electric supply, hospitals, schools, roads, markets, sanitation, etc. In each neighborhood, that means in every area, all of us, we require some essential services. What are those? Water supply, electric supply, hospitals, schools, roads, markets, sanitation. Sanitation means, see, roads all should be cleaned every day. Drains also should be cleaned every day. That all who will do? That government only will look after about these all the essential services. And here we are going to discuss to the changes that have occurred in traveling water and trees in modern times. Now we are going to discuss about what from olden times to modern times, what are the changes are there in traveling, in water and trees in the modern times, from olden times to modern times. In this video, we are going to discuss about traveling and water and trees. Next video, we'll learn. Traveling. Traveling has undergone a great change in recent times. Already you know, early men, they did not know anything. They used to go by walk only. They wherever they want to go, they used to go by walk. After the invention of the wheel only, there is a rapid change in the improvement in the development in the field of means of transport. Already you know that. Today, different means of transport are available for the convenience of the people. Today, so many means of transport are there for the people. And many guest houses, restaurants, night shelters, motors, hotels provide comfort and safety to the travelers. Before that, in previous videos, we discussed it. Those kings, they used to construct the dharmasalas or sarais. There only these travelers used to take shelter. But nowadays, in every area, restaurants are there, guest houses are there, night shelters, hotels, motels, all are there, and they will give comfort to the travelers and safety also. Better roads, bridges and flyovers ensure the smooth movement of the vehicles. So now before that, not there. Those are means of transport, roads, railways, all not there. But nowadays, so many bridges are there, better roads are there, flyovers are there. So much improvement is there in the field of means of transport. And fast and more comfortable means of transport make traveling a pleasure. Faster and more comfortable. That means faster, you know, so many trains are there. Metro express are there. Fast trains are there. Shatabdi express like that. Rajdhani express. And in aeroplanes also. That all give traveling to the people a pleasure. That means happily they can travel to from one place to another place. They may be cars, buses, trains, aeroplanes or ships. Whatever it may be, they are traveling comfortably with the help of means of transport in modern times. See, these are all the means of transport in modern times. Aeroplane, train, ship, bus, car, motorbike, all. Now, bicycle. I think all you can ride a bicycle, no children? Now see what is the importance of bicycle riding. See, bicycle riding is popular all over the world. It makes our body fit, saves fuel and is environment friendly. So bicycle riding is very good for our health also. Why? Because in these bicycles no need to use any fuel. See, any car you take, bike you take, if you keep petrol or diesel, then only it will run. But for these bicycles no need to fill any fuel. We have to ride on the bicycle, then we will be very fit and we will be also very healthy if you do bicycle riding, and it saves fuel, and from that bicycle we won't get any pollution also. That's why we can say that bicycle riding makes our body fit, saves fuel and is environment friendly. So that means very far away places means we can't go by bicycle, but near place we can go by bicycle. So I think all of you understand the lesson. Now a small assignment for you. Water harvesting saves dash from getting drained and wasted. Dash solves the problem of water scarcity. List any four modern means of transport. Thank you.